Thank you so much for coming out tonight to celebrate with us. We are so excited for all the things we have planned tonight. I just wanted to let you all know that after the service, for the friends and family of the seniors, we'll be having a reception, so please feel free to stay for that. Otherwise, here is our youth band, and including both of our seniors. I hope that you enter into worship with us and just let the presence of the Lord move through this place.
Sufficient, instant, all sufficient. goodness of God. I would agree, me and Nate, we've been through a lot of stuff through this year, through our high school years. And God has just been so faithful to us. He did miracles in our lives, and He built us, raised us, helped us. He's been through with us throughout our high school years, so I just feel led to sing goodness of God.
Call out the B on a roll for each grade, and they will also receive their report. report cards, so when I call your name, please come on up. And I'm looking around, I don't have very many students here, but I see one, so thank you for coming. Okay, we're gonna start with the fourth grade. Katie Battaglia, the honor roll. Kaylin Dyers, come on up here. The honor roll, Kaylin, I'm proud of you. Kelsey Wallace is not here, but she also made the B honor roll. That was the fourth grade, this is the fifth. Ava Gallion, she's proud of all of you students. Joshua Thomas is in the sixth grade, and he made the B honor roll. Truth Han, B honor roll. And last but not least is Landon Holden. He made the B honor roll. And parents, I just want to thank you for everything. Thank you for your help, your support. And it's been a joy teaching your children this year. Thank you.
Acadamy, just like the other night, they were going Arkansas, Little Rock, Oklahoma, Oklahoma City, and I can get a few of them. I think Baton Rouge for Louisiana, you know what it is. But they do them all. They just say them all. How many of y'all could do all the states and the capital? And then how many of y'all can call all the presidents that we've ever had in America and go all the way up through right now? And it just amazes me. And then I've seen them before over the years. I mean, whole chapters of the Bible. I've seen them one year do the 11th chapter of Hebrews. You ought to go read that and see if you could read it a few times. And I see different ones nodding their head now because they were part of it and they can do it. Some of them can still do it. And you know, the thing about Christian Academy that I'm so thankful for is, you know, we're living in a time whenever there's been a huge attack against the churches. How many of y'all know that? Even during COVID, they tried to make churches, and they succeeded in some places. They tried to make churches not go to church, to shut the doors, just all kind of deals, regulation on them and all kind of stuff. And they succeeded in some states. Some churches actually went out. I saw signs even around here that said, close until further notice. You know, I saw one go almost a year that said that on the church marquee. But the thing that I appreciate that I was sitting there thinking a little bit about is these kids that they get a little bit of Bible when they come here, you know, every day. They study the Word of God. They do, I think, three pledges? The Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. We've had people come and force it. We don't pledge allegiance to nobody but God. Well, if you don't pledge allegiance, if you're not proud of America, then you don't belong here, okay? I'm sorry, go to the country that you're proud of. You know, so we here at this Christian Academy, we pledge allegiance to the Christian flag, we pledge allegiance to God's holy word, and they pledge allegiance to the American flag because we're American. And all, but what I was thinking is they're fasting, you know, in the day and age that we're living in, and all this is scriptural and biblical, and all evil men and seducers will get worse and worse. And if you don't know that that's going on, then you got your head stuck in the sand because there's an attack on Christianity and the values that the Word of God teaches. How many of y'all know there is a difference between male and female?
Yes.
Well, some of them in the world don't know that. And they're trying to teach them in the schools. They're trying to teach them the transgender stuff. And all you have to do is look at the plumbing and you'll know about it. Get me started. But you know, here's the thing. And in the beginning, God created male and female. That's how he created them. And he said the bed is undefiled in marriage. You understand what I'm talking about? And marriage is between man and woman. You know, so I'm sorry if I'm upsetting somebody, but I'm saying we're going to teach them what the Word of God says around here in that little short time that we have. The teachers do, I mean, and of course the staff and all. And the thing that I was thinking, this is what's so important. The psalmist David said, "Thy word, the Word of God, have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee." And how many of y'all, now I'm talking to parents right now, how many of y'all have been going to do, anybody ever done anything wrong? You know what was wrong with them?
Oh, yeah. We didn't do
that. We all have that. And how many of y'all, though, felt before you did it, the Holy Spirit was right there saying, don't do that. Come on, don't do that. Or don't tell that lie, tell the truth. Come on, whatever it is, the Holy Spirit was right there on the spot, on the job, convicting us. You know what I'm talking about. Well, see, when the little ones get taught and trained, they get the Word of God in their heart, like Psalms David says, "Thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee." See, they can take the Bible away from me and be okay. I don't like that. I wouldn't want it. I wouldn't want it for the sake of people that don't know it, you know, hadn't read it as much as I've read it, okay? It's not that I know more than other people do. But when we read the Word of God and we study the Word of God, and these children, I say kids sometimes, they get that instilled in them all the way from the before, I guess.
K-3-year-olds.
Yeah. How do you say it?
3-year-olds.
The 3-year-old all the way up to these graduates here, they get some of the Word of God instilled in them every day when they come to a Christian Academy. it's not our doctrine, your doctrine, but it's Bible doctrine. It's what God says. See, we don't care. I don't have an opinion. I have to say, when somebody says, what do you think about this? What do you think about that? It no matter what I think, it's what God said. So I have to go on what God said. So here again, if they do apprehend, take all the Bibles away, like they're trying to take a lot of liberties away and a lot of freedom away, well, guess what? They can't steal the Word of God out of your heart, my heart, if we put it in there, if we've learned it. So I just praise the Lord for the privilege we've had. Frances, I'm kind of speaking to her right now. She's gone goofing off a little bit with her two daughters. And she would tell you, we talk about it a lot of time, we're so thankful for all of you as parents that have supported the Acadamy by sending us your children and entrusting us with them. And then I'm so thankful for the faculty, the staff, the teachers, and all that we have here that love your children just like their own. You know, they feel that way. And we try to look after them and see that their safety and everything. And anything that you've ever done to help us in that, well, we appreciate it from the bottom of our heart. But what a privilege it is to be able to teach the children and have a school, have a church, a school within the church, where we can provide that for people that want it. Because, you know, my kids started learning some stuff in the public schools that I didn't want them to learn there. I wanted to teach them, okay? Or Francis wanted to teach them. So we're going to try to keep things biblically straight, strong, doctrinally sound, and just go by the things we feel that God would be pleased with us instilling your children. So thank you for support. Thank you for our staff. And man, I'm so proud of Autumn and our principal, man. And she's doing that to God. Of course, this is like one of my babies, so I guess I was around when you hit planet Earth, but I've been here 48 years. So I think I was here. I don't think you're 48 years young. Okay, and the kids, let me just say real quick, the kids did such an excellent job, the band, and of course, the one-man band tonight on that, and singing and all, and I know you enjoy that because you clap. So God bless you. Let's give Autumn a hand.
Nathan, James, Dice. Thank you for coming out tonight. Thank you for Thank you so much for coming out to support us.